Today's question comes from Wally in Reno. Wally wants to ask, how can we check to see if a domain bought from a registrar was previously in trouble with Google? I recently bought one, and unbeknownst to me, the domain isn't being indexed, and I've had to do a reconsideration request. How could I have prevented that? Great question. Okay, so, you know, you always have a choice. You can start out with a fresh domain that you're registering, or you can try to buy a domain from someone else or from a registrar. And how do you know that you're getting what you paid for, you know, that a spammer hasn't taken this domain and burnt it to the ground? So a few rules of thumb. First off, do a search for the domain, and do it in a couple ways. Do a site colon search, so site colon domain.com, whatever it is you want to buy. If there's no results at all from that domain, even if there's content on that domain, that's a pretty bad sign. If the domain is parked, well, we try to take parked domains out of our results anyway, so that might not indicate anything. But you know, if you try to do site colon and you see zero results, that's often a bad sign. Also, just search for the domain name, or you know, the name of the domain minus the .com or whatever the extension is on the end, because you can often find out a little bit of the reputation of the domain. So were people, you know, spamming with that domain name? Were they talking about it? Were they talking about it in a bad way? Like, this guy was sending me unsolicited email and leaving spam comments on my blog. That's a really good way to sort of figure out what's going on with that site or what it was like in the past. Another good rule of thumb is to use the Internet Archive. So if you go to archive.org and you put in a domain name, the archive will show you what the previous versions of that site looked like. And if the site looked like it was spamming, then that's definitely a reason to be a lot more cautious and maybe steer clear of buying that domain name, because that probably means you might have, the previous owner might have dug the domain into a hole and you have to just do a lot of work even to get back to level ground. So check with archive.org and see if you can find previous versions of the site. You know, if it's auto-generated spammy content, that's a really bad sign and maybe a reason to avoid that domain. Also, you might, if you're talking about buying the domain from someone who currently owns it, you might ask, okay, can you show me either, let me see the analytics or the Webmaster Tools console to check for any messages, or, you know, screenshots, you know, something that would let me see the traffic over time, because if the traffic is going okay and then dropped a lot or has gone really far down, then that might be a reason why you want to avoid the domain as well. If, despite all of that, you buy the domain and you find out, okay, there was some really scuzzy stuff going on and it's got some issues with search engines, you can do a reconsideration request. Before you do that, I would consider, ask yourself, are you buying the domain just because you like the domain name, or are you buying it because of all the previous, you know, content or the links that were buying, coming to it or something like that? If you're counting on those links carrying over, that you might be disappointed because the links might not carry over. And especially if the previous owner was spamming, you might consider just doing a disavow of all the links that you can find on that domain to try to get a completely fresh start whenever you are ready to move forward with it. But overall, if you do a site colon search or you search for the domain name or you look for it in Internet Archive, that's a really fast, quick, easy way to get an idea of whether it was owned by someone that used it for ill or whether they were doing some good stuff with it in the past. Hope that helps.